shows out of the comprehensive plan the different zoning districts that are allowed in these two areas and compared to two. You see that they're fairly similar, transitional neighborhood being the lesser category, mean activity center allowing more intensive commercial zones. As you look at the zoning map, in your packet, you see this is the tail of another neighborhood. This was also a county island that was annexed in 2006. The neighborhood has completely changed character in the past 10 years. Instead of being mostly owner-occupied, it is now mostly renter-occupied or vacant land. One thing that's a little bit different on this one is that it abuts some very intensive commercial development, that being the shopping center to the across St. Augustine Road, and also the Valdosta Mall corners, the Valdosta Mall area itself along Water Drive. The larger of these parcels, of which there are eight, is coming under contact for a commercial developer wanting to put in something that needs either CC or CH zoning. Under the current character area, it is not eligible, so that generated some discussion and raised questions about this whole neighborhood in terms of its future development pattern. A group of property owners have gotten together in terms of the request, so we have letters of authorization and requests from these eight parcels to change their character designation from transitional neighborhood to community activity center. Keep in mind that it's not make the rezoning of the property automatic. This is not a rezoning request. It simply allows these properties to be eligible for a future rezoning request if they want to submit one. So what is before you is simply to allow a possibility of the zoning change. In terms of the rest of the neighborhood, staff is recommending that stay transitional neighborhood for the time being. And all of this is being rethought as part of the comprehensive plan update, will be taking place next year. But keep in mind, you'd just like to see on that handout, transitional neighborhood does offer a wide range of zoning possibilities all the way up through neighborhood commercial. In terms of overall pattern of character areas, you see the very intensive regional activity center associated with the mall and the development along North Drive, and then the community activity center sort of tapering off from that along St. Augustine Road. Being that these properties in proximity to St. Augustine and the mall, the more intensive character area seems appropriate here. There was some discussion at the work session about the established residential area to the east. That is, to the rest of us, known as the Parker Mathis neighborhood, and that is still very much an intact, stable neighborhood. It is separated from this neighborhood by a very wide rangeway, Hightower Creek, wetlands area, so there is a natural boundary, if you will, along St. Augustine Road, between the mall area to the west and the rest of the St. Augustine corridor to the southeast. So the staff is looking at the overall pattern for the intensive character areas nearby, the potential for future redevelopment. And so we're recommending approval of this change of character area on the future development act.
Staff. Commissioners, any questions for staff on this request? There being none, is there anyone here wishing to speak in favor of this request? Please come forward at this time.
Good evening, Board. I'm Richard Bonner. I'm here requesting that
Mr. Bonner, what's your address? I'm sorry.
I'm sorry?
What's your address?
1510 Hickory Road, the subject parcel that we're talking about. I'm here requesting this change in the character map. It's something I believe that the old neighborhood has definitely been waiting for. The properties have changed hands so many times. There are businesses, per se, in our neighborhood. One being, well, it's just a small family business, and there's apartments in the back. The investment folks are involved. I think people have been waiting on someone to pull the trigger on the area. Similar to Mr. Thomas's request, that corridor between 84 and 75, which is now, they call it 133, is an area that is slowly or fast moving, a fast growing area that we can't stop, I don't So it's y'all's position here is to try to control it. And I think it's a good move for the whole neighborhood. Like Mr. Matt said, there's a barrier between us and Remington and the Langford Drive area. I grew up in this area and I've watched it go from a two-lane blacktop road, barn tubby and a dirt road at this end of it. So I think it's a natural course of events is what I really do believe. Everybody in the neighborhood expressed interest to be able to do this. We're only asking for the lots that are before you in order to allow ours to be rezoned at some point for a development.
Any questions
that you might have?
Any questions for the center? I have one quick question, just curiosity. The church that sits there, I believe that's St. Augustine Road Church of Christ.
Yeah.
And there appears to be a lot with a mobile home on that. And I saw where everybody's not. I'm just curious, who owns that lot?
I would say a fellow named Duke owns it. I'm not certain exactly who owns it. I will say this, I don't know the exact number, but I'll just throw these numbers out. There are 20 of the 25 owners expressed their approval to this. So, and the church being one of them, or at least the elders of the church. I didn't see any church disband and move, but, you know, that may be in the future. Who knows? They're sitting right on the road frontage. They've got valuable property. It might be to their benefit to sell, let it be, you know, developed. Put them in a better place. There was some discussion earlier about the school, sit here through all of it. You gotta have schools for kids, and when you have schools, you want people to live near them. So if they're living near them, you're gonna have traffic, and you just gonna have to work it and try to find the ways to manage it, which is what we're asking here. That y'all, you know, take a hard look at it. So this is coming whether you like it or not. Now is your chance to, you know, put your 2 cents in.
Okay. Any questions for presenter? Thank you, sir. Anyone else here wishing to speak in favor of this request? That's your name and address for the record, please, sir.
My name is Stephen Bonner. The property that we're talking about is part of my family's estate.
Stephen, let me stop you. I'm sorry. I need your address.
I'm sorry. I live in Gordon, Georgia. Yes, sir. Middle Georgia. I was raised right there on that hill, and we have watched it change over the last 30 years from rural to residential to commercial. And what we would like to do is be able to sell the property and let the town progress as it has in that direction for the last 30 years.
Understand. Any questions for the president? Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you.
Anyone else wishing to speak in favor?
Yes.
If not, is anyone here wishing to speak against this request? Anyone here wishing to speak against this request? There being none?
I have a question.
I'm sorry, yes, sir. Discussion.
With Gordon Georgia.
Where's Gordon Georgia, sir? Is that around Macon? Where's it at?
It is east of Macon, Georgia.
You good with that? Just want to make sure. You good? Thank you, sir.
I tell everybody I live 50 miles from anywhere. 25 miles of Macon, 25 miles of Millersville, 25 miles of Dublin, and back.
Thank you, sir. Commissioners, any more discussion on this? If not, I will entertain a motion on this request.
Mr. Chairman, I recommend that we give approval for BA 2015-14.
Second. I have a motion and a second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. So passed 6-0. Thank you very much. Based on that, we have